Hello, my name is Youngmin Lee. I am going to talk about improved security analysis for non-spaced NAST hashed mask max. This is joint work with Wonseok Choi, Myung-Hwang Lee, and my advisor Ju-Young Lee. Let's start with the introduction. As everyone knows, MAG is a symmetric key algorithm generating a tag for assuring authenticity of the message. For example, Alice and Bob share the secret key K at the beginning of communication. Alice computes the tag of message M and sends it to Bob. Bob also computes the tag of a given message. Then Bob thinks the given message is valid if the two tags are same. And we call non-spaced MAG if the MAG receives a unique value node with the message. What is MAG security? Assume that an adversary IP which can intercept and manipulate the message. Then the new message and tag pair may not be consistent with the MAG algorithm. So Bob can notice the message does not sent by Alice. To capture this situation, MAG should have unforgeability to be secure. If a MAG has unforgeability, it is infeasible to generate a new valid message and tag pairs. The unforgeability can be modeled as forging game. In forging game, IP can ask Alice a valid tag of message M, which called authentication query, and can ask Bob whether M prime and T prime is valid or not, which called verification query. The forging advantage is defined as the probability that IP forges. To evaluate the upper bound of forging advantage, you can think the following distinguishing game. The distinguisher is interacting with either real world or ideal world. The real world comprises the MAG function, and the ideal world comprises a random variable inference function for authentication queries and a function which always returns reject for verification queries. Then the distinguisher tries to distinguish the two worlds by making Q authentication queries and V verification queries. While making verification queries, if the distinguisher can generate valid message and tag pairs, it can easily distinguish the two worlds. Therefore, the forging advantage is always less than or equal to the distinguishing advantage. The distinguishing advantage of the adversary is defined as a probability of correctly defining the interacting worlds minus a half, which is a probability of winning by simple random guessing. There are two security notions for non-spaced MAG. One is nonce respecting setting, which nonce can be asked once in authentication queries. Another is nonce misuse setting, which nonce can be repeated. Before discussing about the construction we proved, let's briefly introduce well-known nonce-based MAG constructions. Perhaps, the most famous construction is Megamakata MAG, which uses an almost XOR universal hash function and a random function. Because of this nonce input, Megamakata MAG enjoys full security as long as nonce are not repeated. Later, Victor Shub replaced the random function into a random permutation, which can be instantiated with DS or AS. However, using a random permutation instead of a random function degrades the security to the birthday bound. In many cases, the birthday bound is enough, but both constructions are vulnerable when a single nonce is repeated, since the repeated nonce reveals an XOR value of two hash messages. To redeem the weakness of those constructions, one can use one more encryption to encrypt the output value. The resulting construction is called encrypted Wegmann-Cantor soup, and secure up to the birthday bound in both nonce respecting and nonce misuse setting. In non-respecting setting, Wegmann-Cantor construction itself is fully secure since we assume fk is a fully random function. Hence, we may expect that if we replace ek to more secure PRF, the security bound could be improved in non-respecting setting. With this idea, in Crypto 2016, Kogliatti and Surin proposed a new construction called Encrypted Wegmann-Cantor with Davis Mayer, or briefly EWCDM. The only change is adding the nonce in the middle of the construction. However, This modification significantly improved the security bound. As a result, it is secure beyond the burst bound when nonce are not reused. In addition, this construction retains secure up to the burst bound in case of nonce misuse. In Crypto 2018, Dataiter proposed another variant of Wegman Cutter Mech called Decrypted Wegman Cutter with Davis Mayo or DWCDM. Again, a change from EWCDM seems small, but this change makes EWCDM to use only a single block cipher key K. A hash key KH also can be derived from a block cipher VK by encrypting a constant. Hence, EWCDM can be regarded as a beyond burst bound secure MAC with a single key. Let me summarize the previous pages. This table shows security bound of nonce-based MAC we discussed. You can see that this line of research has been continued very recently. And not surprisingly, improvement of nonce-based MAC is still continuing. One of the main issues in nonce misuse setting is that ideally, security should degrade gracefully in case nonce are repeated. So let me introduce another nonce-based MAC construction with graceful degradation in the nonce misuse model. Nonce-based enhanced hashtag mask MAC, the NHTM, is the construction in this slide. It is proposed by Dutta et al. In Eurocrypt 2019. NHTM seems to have similar security bound to EWCDM or DWCDM, but actually have better security since it achieves graceful degradation in the nonce misuse model. When we consider graceful degradation, we denote mu as a number of repeated nonce, which are also called as faulty nonces. The actual proposed security bound is shown like this. The graph shows the threshold number of authentication queries according to the number of faulty nonces. Before 2 to the n over 3 faulty nonce queries, one can observe that the security bound is preserved up to the 2 to the 2n over 3 authentication queries, and then it degrades gracefully. The security bound of NHTM was attained via mirror theory. The mirror theory was first proposed by Patarin in 2010, which evaluates the number of solutions of affine system. Mirror theory sometimes understands a system of equations as a graph by identifying each equation as an edge and each unknown as a vertex. Generally, an affine system identified with an arbitrary graph may have contradiction. Therefore, we define a property called nice, which guarantees no contradiction. Then it makes possible to count the number of solutions. We will talk about this theory more specifically in overview of the proof. NHTM is already shown to secure up to 2n over 3 authentication queries. However, there are no known matching attacks. Actually, we will show that NHTM has better security bound. Then, why the first proposed proof only showed 2n over 3 bounds? Here are two bottlenecks of the proof. The first bottleneck comes from limitation of mirror theory. The mirror theory used in the previous proof assumed the following condition, which is related to maximum component size Xi_max and the number of edges Q. When Q is increased, it is natural that Xi_max would be increased together. Thus, we can easily expect that Q would be bounded far apart from the 2 to the n with this condition. The second bottleneck comes from estimating condition for nice graph. To attain a better security bound, we need to estimate the probability of having nice graph more carefully than before. And sometimes it becomes the most challenging work among our whole group. We organize the improvement of mirror theory in a table in this slide. In this work, we improved mirror theory to free the condition of component size and include known equations, as well as enjoy high security bound. Here, red line is new security bound of NHTM. As you can see, our new bound improved the security of NHTM for any number of faulty nonces up to 2 to the n over 2. Let's introduce the brief overview of our security proof. At first, we replace the block cipher EK by a random permutation pi. And this adds negligible advantage up to the pseudo randomness of the block cipher. Next, we assume that the hash key KH is revealed to the adversary at the end of the interaction. So the adversary can calculate the intermediate value X, which is XOR of hashed message and nonce. Since it is free to ignore this additional information, this does not decrease the advantage. The difference made by this setting is represented as a red colored variable and line in the figure. We use the expectation method, which can be viewed as a generalization of Pattern-less coefficient edge technique, which upper bound the distinction advantage. Let TID and TRE are the probability distribution of a transcript tau in the ideal world and the real world, respectively. Then informally, expectation method tells us if the probability to have a bad transcript is small in the ideal world, the ratio of ideal world and real world is expected to be close to 1, one cannot distinguish the two worlds. I will not cover this precisely, but the important part is to define a proper set of bad transcript and then find the corresponding epsilon ratio. Also, the probability of getting a good transcript in the real world is the most challenging part in the proof. To find out the probability to get a transcript in the real world, we construct a system of equations and count the number of solutions of the system. Let's first focus on authentication queries. Since we have a hash key, we know all of input to permutation pi. Then, as you can see here, the output of pi can be viewed as unknowns, and each query generates an equation of two unknowns. Through this process, one can find out the corresponding system of equations and non-equations from a transcript. To easily represent the system, we visualize the system by a transcript graph G. Each unknown in the system becomes a vertex, and each equation and non-equation become an edge. More precisely, authentication queries are represented by solid edges, and verification queries are represented by dashed edges. Note that if there are faulty nonces or hash collisions, edges might be connected to each other. The figure shows the example of transcript graph which represent two authentication queries and two verification queries. The next step is to define the bad transcript. Some of transcript graph might lead to a contradiction. Let's denote G equal a partial graph of G consists of vertex step V and set of solid edges. If the G equal contains the cycle, then the system of equations may become inconsistent. And if G equal contains a path whose taxon is equal to zero, one will get the equality of two different unknowns, but this leads to contradiction, because different inputs should be mapped into different outputs through permutations. Although the cycle in G equal with zero taxon does not have contradiction, but for the simplicity, we will identify this as a bad case. Finally, if G contains a cycle with exactly one dashed edge whose taxon is zero, one will derive both equality and non-equality for the same equation. Now let's find the detailed bad events. Bad 1 holds if either bad 1a holds or bad 1b holds. Bad 1a is the event which have length 2 cycle, and bad 1b is the event which have one direction of length 4 trail. Since our graph is always bipartite, all cycles should have an even length, and G equal is always a cyclic without have bad 1. Bad 2 holds if n least 1 of bad 2a to bad 2e holds. Its sub-event represent different shape of paths with zero taxon, and without having bad 2, you can avoid paths of zero taxon in G equal. Finally, bad 3 holds if either bad 3a or bad 3b holds. Each represents a different case to have a cycle in G with exactly one dashed edge whose taxon is zero. To sum up, without having bad 1, bad 2, and bad 3, the graph does not have contradiction. And the probability to get a bad transcript is very small, as you can see in the inequality. What is left is to analyze good transcript by applying mirror theory. For a good transcript, one can observe that the partial graph G equal consists of three groups of components. G3 is the group of components that contains rank 3 traits so that there should be both of 40 null scores and hash collisions. G2 is the group of components that contains rank 2 traits, so each component just have either 40 nonces or hash collisions. Therefore, we figure out that the number of components in G3 is much smaller than those in G2, and the number of components in G2 is much smaller than those in G1. So, to get a sharp estimation of epsilon ratio, we try to make a specialized mirror theory that uses the previous observation. And here is our result. Therefore, we could find sufficiently sharp estimation of epsilon ratio. Finally, after applying the expectation method, we get the security bound of NHTM. The equation is quite complicated. The important dominant term is the over two lines. Here is the conclusion. We proved the 3n over 4 bit security of NHTM using specialized mirror theory. And security bound gracefully degrades when mu is less than 2 to the n over 2 in non-smissive setting. There are some future works. I said, we proved the improved security bound, however, there are no matching attacks, so the security could be better than that. Another interesting problem is constructing an authenticated encryption with high security bound based on this analysis. Thank you for listening, and if you have any question, please send it to me to the following email.